And then if you want to just, you know, just cut the yeah, chop the sure, capers a little. I like to tell my mom what to do in the kitchen because I have so much more culinary experience than she does. Today marks the release date of my book, Always Home. So we are going to cook a recipe, the two of us, out of this book. And we're going to do that from home because these days, everyone is always home all the time. I'm here with my mom, Alice Waters, who is a cook. You may have heard of her. We are going to make a recipe that we ate all the time when I was a kid. And it's one of those really indelible memories of childhood. We would get back from a trip and there'd be almost nothing in the house to eat. And we would rummage around and find some old pasta. And there was usually reliably a little bit of good garlic still left in the pantry and good olive oil always. And then you would just embroider a little. If we had some nice anchovies, we would use those. If we had capers, we'd use those. In essence, this recipe is kind of like one of those super simple Italian recipes. And today we're going to use garlic, anchovy, capers, parmesan, a little bit of lemon zest, and a lot of parsley and olive oil. So the first thing to do is to put a pot of water on to boil. And you want to salt your water very generously.
Is this finely chopped enough?
Well, you know, I would use 5 times that amount of garlic, but I accept. Yeah, that looks good.
For this small amount of pasta.
For that small amount of pasta. Pasta for quarantine for two, I think we're looking good. I'm also going to chop these anchovies. I really like the way the anchovy tastes when it's actually had a moment to cook with the garlic and mingle in the frying pan. All right, so I'm going to add a little bit of olive oil to the pan.
And there's a little trick that's very important. You put the garlic in right when the olive oil is warming up.
That way, if you put it in beforehand, it actually warms the garlic as it warms the oil, and you never get caught off guard and burn your garlic. Mom, do you want to toss in the anchovy? I'm going to turn up the lid. So the heat now on the pan is sort of medium-low. I love chilies, love them. So I would put this entire dish in, but I'm going to try and respect the boundaries of my mother's palate because we have a lot of time that we've been spending together recently in quarantine. Just, you know. So just a pinch, but you can add as much chili as you like.
Exactly, at the table.
You cannot take out, but you can always add. So this does not apply, unfortunately, to baking, which I think is why neither of us are great bakers. Capers next, and then turn the heat down a little bit. Starting to smell fragrant, it's delicious.
Plus, it's gonna take about 8 or 10 minutes. And it doesn't matter if your preparation is made ahead of time. You can do that, and then just get the pasta right at the right time.
Is that enough parm, do you think?
Maybe a little more.
Create a little bit more.
Oh!
Got a little chunk there. So I think it's probably ready.
Do you think?
Do you want to toss it right into the pan?
Yeah. It's okay to have a little water in there.
Yeah, it's in fact, it's a good thing to have a little of the pasta water in there because then it gives you a little lubrication. Toss some of the parsley in there. Grind some black pepper?
Yeah.
Yeah. So much black pepper.
So much black pepper. You always want to taste. Always. Just to check.
Mm. Is that good? You need anything? A little lemon zest?
Maybe, yep. I think a little lemon zest.
If you have it, a lemon that is. A little lemon zest at this stage is nice because it just brightens.
This is very savory with the anchovies and the garlic and the capers and sort of salty and good. And so that it just kind of cuts it to have a lemon at the end. We always taste at Chez Panisse right at that moment. We all taste it.
Thank you.
and just check to see if there's any last minute touch.
And I'm gonna just, little squeeze of lemon juice. Mm-hmm. I'm actually gonna add just the last little bit of parsley.
Yes,
there.
All the parsley.
All the parsley, she says. I was holding back, but it's always nice too to use a little splash of fresh olive oil at the end, not just the oil that you've been cooking with, because the oil that you cooked with will oxidize slightly. And you add it at the end, you get that really pungent, delicious flavor of olive oil.
Okay. All right.
I think we're ready. Just a little parm over top. Last little cream of lemon zest. Squeeze the juice. Voila.